that you're here to share some memories of our mother and celebrate her life. She would love that we were holding it here. She loved this village, and she loved all of Oceanside. And this is where we had their 50th wedding anniversary. This is where we had the memorial for my dad in 2002. So it's wonderful that we would have it here today. And she arranged for really good weather, what do you say? The parking, not so much. But she loved this village. She found that spot. She always felt that building that house was the best work she did in her life. And I said, well, what about Chris and I? And she said, they lived here for 28 years, and my mom lived here on and off until she was 90. And she still loved it, even being up there alone. They say everybody's story starts with a mother. Happily, ours was a gem.
Yeah.
One of her best traits was playfulness. Yeah. She was so much fun. There's a lot of people in this room that know that. She loved music.
Yes.
And that's one of the reasons Craig Cathy is here. My mom was an avid journalist. And from the time she was little, over on that table we have her diaries from 1936 and 1937. That's when she was just 14. And I'll give you some quotes from that in a minute. But she wrote in her journal in 2014 about Craig. She wrote about him every time he showed up. He was in her journal. Here's a quote from her journal. Craig Cathy, the wonderful pianist, will be here in a half an hour to entertain us. I really look forward to his visits. He plays in the northwest corner of the dining room, and he uses no music, so it is all very original, by ear, and I love it. And from 2013, another one. I went to hear Craig Cathy. He was great on the piano, as usual. He's worth a whole month's rent. So she loved music. She played the piano when we were little. And she even gave piano lessons, but we were too ornery to learn. But she played the piano and encouraged us to dance. We can remember her playing throughout our childhood and beyond. And we vividly remember a piece that she played that's called In a Persian Market, where we performed in costume. And I think my cousin Jack is the caliph.
Where he had a pillow on his head.
She was adventurous. Back in the 50s, when there were way fewer people out here, we lived in Neatards, she would sometimes speed through those two big hills in Neatards, you know, those two big hills as you're leaving town, and then try to coast all the way to Whiskey Creek Summit. And we cheered from the back seat. She took us on adventures to the lighthouse. Back when there was only a one-lane gravel road to reach it, one with signs that read, sound horn on corners, because of oncoming logging trucks. We climbed the octopus tree and we dashed along those cliffs before there were any railings up there. And we're grateful for those adventures. We remember them. She immersed us in music, even joining the Columbia Record Club for Children so we could receive a long playing album every month to encourage singing and dancing. We have her check register, because she saved everything, from those years, and it cost her $1.88 a month. But we love those records, and Chris and I can still sing some of those songs.
We're building a city, we're building a city, digging and pounding, we're working all together.
For long, rainy, indoor days of winter, they were incredibly fun. just like she was. She taxied us to all our activities in town, and then they finally decided they would move into Tillamook. We were 12 and 13. And she always wanted to return to live near the ocean. And she searched for a lot to build on. After we were grown and married, she always felt that building that house was the best thing she ever did. And all of us that have stayed there many, many times agree. She loved being here even after Daddy died. And when her hearing went, she didn't have to hear the howling winter storms. And in a place like this, people have to help each other. And she came down here more than once to the post office with a jar of mayonnaise for the postmaster to open it for her. if you look at her journals, they're she wrote so darn tiny in single space, so they're hard to read, but you can guess they're pretty special to us. So here's a few entries from 1937. Ray has given me Walnettos in science every day. Ray gave me a box of candy for Valentine's. Then the very next day, didn't do much today, but try to avoid Ray. He's such a pest. But by summertime, she wrote, Ray came down around 2:30, we read the funnies. And later, we played ball. I walked home with Ray and stayed and watched him milk. And later, on my way from my piano lesson, I stopped and talked to Ray while he weeded strawberries. So the rest is history. They were together after that. She kept meticulous records of everything, and she loved clipping things from the newspaper. But in those files, when we were cleaning them out, we found some treasures. And these were all from the Headlight Herald in the Oceanside column that she saved. This is from 1981. Ray and Evie Milner, who live on Maxwell Mountain, are back in their home again and happy to find an end to the question, when are you moving back? The storm of November 14th took a large section of their roof off. They have been living in Tillamook while their house was being repaired. Neighbors surprised them with a sign that said, welcome back to the summit. from years when they went down to Indio in the winter, another column mentioned them. Ray and Ev are back from the desert looking wonderful. We all welcome them back because the mountain and the town are not the same without them. During the 5 months they were gone, there were only 9 times the winds hit 60 miles an hour. The wind today clocked in at 72. Feeling like you are home again, Ray and Ev? But we love this entry. This is from 2004. This just in, Evie Milner has escaped the home. And she's back in Oceanside. Did I mention there was a twinkle in her eye? Now, this was after Daddy had died, and she had met Walt Stein. A late in love life. How many people late get to fall in love when they're 81? Chris and I are grateful to Walt because he gave her a late in life love after she'd lost her dear sister Dorothy and her dad and our dad, too. He gave her adventures in dancing, fishing, and winters in Yuma. So he contributed a lot to the last years of her life. Here's a quote I stumbled upon that I think is appropriate. Your children, when grown, won't remember how clean your house was. But they will remember how you looked when you smiled and the sound of your laughter long after you're gone. Our mother had a great sense of humor.
Amen.
Even about losing her memory. She was painfully aware of her mind becoming addled. She told us in her early 90s she was trying to keep a low profile at Five Rivers so they wouldn't move her to the other end. She would often say, when people asked how she was, She would say she was circling the drain. Mm-hmm. Or she was this close to leaving the planet. When she did leave the planet in mid-May at Country Haven in Tillamook, she slipped away peacefully without any pain, and I'm hoping that she had that little grin on.